What are you making there, Rafa? Which one do you want? This one? The spaghetti? Okay, let's move it over. Yeah, nice. So I'm downstairs again with the kids. You want to take a picture of me? Okay. So today we're downstairs with Raphael and Levi. And as Raphael plays with the Play-Doh just over there, I just want to very quickly show you something. Now, I showed you this in a previous video, but I think it was worth doing another video about just this, because it shows the power of something called paleobotany. It's botany done in the geological record. Check this out. A few videos ago, I showed you a fossil over here. Here it is, right here. It's a leaf. Unmistakably, some kind of leaf. Now, botanical studies show that different kinds of plants and trees grow in different kinds of soils. So, would it be possible to identify the plant or tree where that fossilized leaf came from? And if it is, then maybe you can say something, not just about what grew back in the Cretaceous 120 million years ago, but what kind of soil it grew in. And if we know what kind of soil it came from, then maybe we can say something about the geology underneath the soil. So, what kind of plant does that leaf actually come from? Well, unfortunately, I'm a geochemist, so I don't really know. But I happen to know somebody in my geology department who is a paleobotanist. So I suggest we go and ask her. So I'm here at university in the geology department at the Federal University of Pernambuco, and we're about to go and meet Paula, and she's a paleobotanist.
Oi, Paula.
Oi, Fred.
Tudo bem?
Tudo bem.
Certo. Beleza? Você recebeu meu e-mail?
Recebi seu e-mail.
Então, temos o que aqui?
Uma espécie de conífera.
Conífera, certo.
Isso. Muito comum na formação crato da bacia do Araripe, chamado braquifílio.
Ah, que pena. Eu pensei que foi uma coisa extraordinária.
Ela é extraordinária, mas ela não é...
Não é raro.
Incomum.
Tem uma amostra aqui que pode me mostrar?
Tem, tá ali, ó.
Você pode escrever o nome dessa planta?
Okay,
so what we have here is the name, the exact species of the plant that we have in my apartment. This is great news. So now we can go away and find out what kind of soil it grows in to see maybe what the underlying geology was afterwards. Paula, muito obrigado, viu?
De nada, prazer.
Okay, demais.
Tchau.
Now, the genera of the plant that Paula gave me is actually extinct, but the family has continued until the present day. So by understanding the ecology, where that family of plant lives in today, we can say a lot about the ecology, what it used to be like in the Cretaceous period in that part of Brazil. So I found out, after a bit of digging, I found that the name of this plant here. Okay, so now we found out that in all likelihood, the soil in which that little fragment of fossilized conifer came from in my apartment was acidic. And that's really amazing because there's only so many ways that soils can become acidic. And to find out the most likely reason, I'm going to take you on a very short trip back to BODMIN, MOOR, near to where I grew up in the UK. There is full of plants which love acidic soils. Thank you. I'm here in the southwest of England. This is the modern day. And what we have here is bracken, one of the most common plants you see on the moors in southwest of England. Bracken is special because it only grows in acidic soils. And the soils are acidic around here because the underlying rock, which in this case is granite, is very abundant. So what happens is the granite is gradually eroded and its components leach into the soil, acidifying that soil, which is an ideal substrate for this bracken. So by studying the modern botany, we can say that 120 million years ago, back in Brazil, in that area of Brazil, the underlying rock was granite.
Now we have a hypothesis. We don't actually know for sure if there was granite in that area. So our theory is not complete yet. We haven't really proved it at all. But I know somebody at the university again called Tiago. He's just finished his PhD, who knows that area of Brazil very, very well. So we can go and ask him. Tiago, tudo bem, cara?
Tudo bom.
Beleza. Tenho uma pergunta para você.
Beleza.
O que está embaixo de Fumação Crato, Fumação Santana?
Na borda norte central da bacia do Guararipe, tem o embasamento formado por ortognites, um protólito de granito.
Sim.
E após o embasamento, a gente tem a formação cariri.
Certo.
Que são arenitos.
Uhum.
E em determinada região, próximo à formação cariri, a gente já tem a formação crato.
Então, essa que era granito, né? Transformado, né? Esse granito, ele fica embaixo de tudo?
Sim, esse granito, ele fica embaixo de tudo.
So it's morning again, which means I'm on daddy duty with Raphael and Levi downstairs, but I hope you've enjoyed this journey. Now, I had some specialist help from my colleagues at university, but in fact, any member of the public could have done what I'd done. Well, these days you can just take a picture and upload it to Google Images and it will find something similar. Eventually you would have found the identification of that little plant fragment. And then with a little bit more digging, you could have found out about the soil acidity and the modern equivalent and where it grows and what the climate is. And with a bit more digging, you would have found out about, you know, how soils form. And you could have already made some educated guesses about what it was like 120 million years ago. Anybody could have done it. I simply used my colleagues because it was faster. For me, to sum up, it's absolutely amazing that you can find out so much detail about the climate, the precipitation, the acidity of the soil, and even the regional geology based on one tiny fragment of leaf. And that is the power of paleobotany.